So for this demo, we need to capture some events. We will do it based on the subnet creation and destruction for the purpose of the demonstration. So let's first start by seeing a bit the environment. We have a solid server with currently no spaces named with a demo in their name. We will create one for the purpose. The creation will be done with Terraform because it's easier. So I made a small script using our Terraform provider in order to build a space. So the space will have a name starting by demo. And then we will create a block using the full 10/8 range. And within this space, we will create a non-terminal network, 10.0.16.0/20, with four terminal subnets inside, two with 24 subnets, 24 bits subnet, and two with 25 bits subnet. So let's create that first. We will init our environment. I already get the solid server version. That's the current provider version, 1.1.14. So it's initialized, and let's apply that in order to create our okay. So now we should have our space. Here we are. The name is randomed. No problem. So here we have all our subnets. So I created that with Terraform because it's easier to afterwards to destroy and recreate. But for sure you can do it with the directly to the IPAM. Easy, no problem with that. So the next steps are to configure the event forwarding. I've made a very simple integration. The first one that will use a tool that you may know called Pushbullet. It's a kind of chat application, very easy to integrate in order to share some information. So on Pushbullet, there is a simple API that you can use to push a notification to someone, and that's what I will create in the solid server. So we have a specific rule to do that. Is a very specific rule named 412. So this rule is executed on a regular basis. I put it every minute, but you can adjust that for your own purpose. And the idea is to use an endpoint here, the endpoint of Pushbullet, and we will have a look to this to the description of the forward policy, but we will do that in the editor. It's gonna be easier. So we describe here the whole policy we will use for Pushbullet. Here, what we say is that we want to grab events from the user tracking. So any action performed by a user or an API call can be grabbed, but we would like to filter events. So here we have made a very, very strict filter because it needs to be an add command, and it need on top of that to use the IP subnet add endpoint. So here we will grab only actions on the creation or the modification of a subnet. Then we describe how we will talk to the Pushbullet API. Here we are using a post a REST API call with specific headers. We will provide a content which is a JSON, and I got a specific access token. That's the one linked to my application. And then I build a specific content because that's the one expected by Pushbullet. I need to push a note with a title and a body, and inside the body I use a variable substitution, and I would like to get from the event the address of the subnet I will create. So this is typically what I have put in my policy, cut and paste, and then the policy is active. Just gonna check whether it's effectively active. Yes, this one is active. So since I've grabbed the creation of a subnet, I'm gonna first destroy a subnet. Let's take this one for example. Let's destroy it, and once it's done, I will use the Terraform script, because Terraform will see that the subnet has been destroyed, and it will ask to create one new. Okay, and then we have in our. So here we got the subnet that has been recreated. We have the whole configuration, and then we are expecting to get a notification directly in Pushbullet. And I got the notification in Pushbullet. So it's very simple notification. With the title I put in my JSON description for the forward policy, and the address of the subnet that has just been recreated. Cool. That's a good one. Okay. So now second integration, a bit different with IFTTT, where I created a very simple applet, like they say. So this applet is exposing an API endpoint that I will call for any deletion of a subnet, and it will send a notification to Pushbullet. Roughly the same as what we've seen. Okay. So this applet received the web request, then push a note to directly my account on Pushbullet. So for this specific event that will grab deletion and send that back to IFTTT, we have a specific template which is quite the same, but for sure the format is different. Here we have we don't have the credential in the header. The credential is directly in the endpoint, and the content is a bit different. We do push multiple values. Here we push the IP address, the start IP address, the subnet name, and also the site name. And those values, which are defined in the content, we can get those back directly in our IFTTT applet, where we have made a very specific title, like subnet deleted with the value 1. Remember that value 1 here is the IP address of the start of the subnet. And in the message, we have the date of this event. And also, we put back the three values we have inside the content. So let's activate this rule and see how it's configured. It's almost quite the same as the previous one. So here, that's an event that will grab the delete. We're gonna run it every minute as well. We grab the delete and we grab the IP subnet delete, so it's very restrictive. Okay, and this specific rule, we have to activate it. So I'm gonna enable this one. And let's go for that. So now we have all our subnet, the rule is activated. Let's drop one. Let's drop this one, for example. And seems that we have the notification. So effectively, here it's a bit more furnished. We have the IP address, the date, the subnet, the name, and also the space where this subnet has been created. So it's quite interesting. And for sure, we can mix both information. So if I do recreate the subnet, which was missing, I will have the notification as well. Here we are. So both event forwarders are working. One directly to Pushbullet for the subnet creation. That's the one we have at the top here. And one through IFTTT. That can be any orchestration system. That's just what the purpose of the example here. We use this public tool. Hope you enjoyed this this demo, and we'll give you some good ideas for your integration. Have fun. Bye.